Like most people, farmers have certain ways of doing things that are comfortable and have stood the test of time. However, with the arrival of COVID-19 in our daily lives, we may need to rethink the common ways we have done things. Let's take a fresh look at each task to see how it may need to be adjusted or modified to meet social distancing requirements for minimizing the spread of the virus. While many farming operations are solitary by nature, some crops, like tobacco, hemp, and many vegetable crops, require cooperation among a number of workers. Social distancing and good hygiene are recommended practices to slow the spread of COVID-19. Social distancing means avoiding unnecessary contact with others and maintaining at least a 6-foot separation between people when they must work together. It may also mean providing a physical barrier between people or providing personal protective equipment or PPE when working conditions require workers to be closer together. Protecting your workers and yourself begins with good communication. Do not assume that everyone already knows about the virus and understands your expectations for protecting your farm. When your workers first arrive on the farm, provide them with initial training on COVID-19 and the methods you are implementing to reduce the chance of spread on your farm. Social distancing goes against human nature, so we all need frequent reminders of the expectations. Place signage reminding workers about spacing requirements and hand washing procedures in places where workers gather frequently, such as housing, common tool areas, and break areas. Encourage workers to call you if they are not feeling well and have a plan in place to isolate potentially ill workers. When working in a greenhouse, provide separate workstations for each worker, spaced at least 6 feet apart. Provide materials for frequent disinfection of hands, tools, and work surfaces. Each worker should be instructed to conduct a thorough cleanup of their workstation at the end of each work shift. For assembly line work, care should be taken to avoid cross-contamination of workstations through the passing of materials from worker to worker. When loading trays of plants, like hemp, tobacco, or tomatoes, give each worker individual tasks to minimize contact. Provide masks and gloves when workers will be crossing paths. Discard or disinfect used personal protective equipment after each shift. Most transplanters require two or more workers sitting on fixed seats less than 6 feet apart. So you may be asking yourself, how can we safely transplant and reduce the spread of the virus? Some strategies for accomplishing this might include creating work teams, preferably of workers who share a household or are roommates already, and ensure that those teams always work together as units and minimize contact with other work teams. Provide masks and gloves for all workers who must be less than 6 feet apart. You could provide a physical barrier between workers that are less than 6 feet apart. Here's an example of planting vegetables on a raised bed with a transplanter that typically requires 2 people per row. In this case, they've slowed down the ground speed so that only 1 person is required to ride on the back of the transplanter. For field operations like chopping out weeds, topping tobacco or hemp, or staking tomatoes, encourage workers to spread out across the field and avoid clumping together in one area. At the beginning of the row, stagger the starting time of each worker to encourage sufficient spacing. Discourage congregating at breaks and provide individual water bottles as opposed to a shared water cooler to avoid cross-contamination during breaks. Provide soap and water for frequent hand washing. COVID-19 concerns will likely continue into the late summer and fall, so consider ways to help workers maintain social distancing to minimize spread during harvest and post-harvest operations as well. When stripping hemp and tobacco or sorting vegetables, provide each worker with a separate workstation. Instead of passing stalks from person to person to remove each grade, have one worker remove all the grades and create individual containers for each grade. The use of stripping chains and tobacco to convey the sticks past the workers and eliminate the passing of stalks may also help to maintain social distancing in tobacco stripping rooms. Let's all do our part to slow the spread of the virus while allowing our workers to complete the essential work of farming.